For more content like this, log on to gibbopresents.com.
It's Gibbo, and right now I'm once again joined by an artist who relocated to Canada in 2005, but who was born and raised in Manchester and Clarendon, Jamaica. It is countryman Exco Levi. Exco, how are you?
Wagwan Gibbo. Good.
Everything is good. It would be wrong of me if I didn't start by congratulating you on being nominated for the Reggae Recording of the Year Juno Awards for the fifth year running. An award which you have won for the past 4 years.
Well, you know, I have to give thanks, you know what I mean? Migrated to Canada in 2005, you know, and understand what the Juno is, knowing that this year is the 45th annual Juno Awards. That means it's before me born. And you know, and if you look at the categories, you realize that Jake is nominated for Artist of the Year. This is Canada's most prestigious award. If you're a musician in Canada and you don't want the Juno, you know, it's just taboo. You know, I mean, so I give thanks for a youth who born in Manchester, migrated to Canada, doing reggae music, doing positive music, to be nominated for my fifth Juno Award. It's a joy. I mean, I'll show you one of the Juno right now, give a don't move. So, this one is Welcome the King. You see that? Look, find it heavy in there. We are on 10 pounds. Welcome the King. Hold on. This one is Storms of Life. You don't know. You know, Storms of Life was produced by Silly Walks out of Hamburg, Germany. Real better than them. See? All right, don't move. This one is called Strive, produced by Silly Walks with me and Kabaka Pyramid. Yeah? And you don't know, the first one that I won in 2012, I brought it to Jamaica. Okay, you know, Penthouse Records, I record Penthouse. So let's give Donovan Jeremy one. So my next win, I'm going to give Silly Walks the one. Good for having a collection, you know? Big up.
I believe you're the first artist to win the Reggae Juno 4 years in a row, but there can't be many people, if any, who've won a Juno in any category in five consecutive years. Do you know how many times, if at all, this has been done before?
I believe there's a girl who sing. She won seven times consecutively. I don't remember her name at the moment, I don't want to lie, but she won seven times. But for the rest of the category, it never happened before. I'm the first.
Will you be nervous at all on the night of the awards, or does the fact that the decision is out of your hands mean that this won't be the case?
Well, it won't be the case, because I mean, every year the Juno is judged by a panel of people across Canada. What they do, they select like 8 judges from across Canada who play reggae music, and they are the one who choose the winner. So I mean, you know, just to be nominated is a plus for me. If I won, I'll be gracious, you know, but there are other musicians too who deserve a chance and deserve to win too. So may the best song win, you know.
Your single which received the nomination is Hello Mama, once again produced by Silly Walks Disco on the Ram Jam rhythm, which I have to say was one of my favorite rhythms of last year. And as you mentioned, this is not the first time you've recorded for the guys from Hamburg. What is it about them and their production that appeals to you? Why do you work well with them?
Well, you know, I mean, Josh and Ollie, big up on yourself, you know. You don't know, I've known these guys from 2012 on to 2013 when I recorded my first song for Penthouse Record. They reach out to me online and said they want to work with me, want to do some recording with me. And my first song that I recorded for Silly Walks that released is Storms of Life, which is still one of my biggest songs in Europe. And because of that song, I've traveled across the continent many times singing, you know. And so it's just a chemistry. You know, just like I have a chemistry with Penthouse Records, the same thing, I have a chemistry with Silly Walks. You know, music is an energy. So once the energy of the producer is right and the energy of the artist is right and it clash, it's a bomb. So it's always a joy working with Silly Walks of Germany. Yeah, man, and it's also a joy to see where they're coming from and to see the growth, you know, because some of the finest reggae songs in the last 3 years coming on is produced by Silly Walks. Yeah, man.
I need to ask you about a recent Instagram post in which you revealed you're forming your own sound system. It seemed like you were unhappy with the way some sounds and selectors play at events in Canada. Can you explain why you have decided to start your own sound HP movement?
Well, listen, really and truly, I mean, I live in this country for 10 years, or just a little bit over 10 years, you know, and I can't complain about the support that I get from radio station, from media in general, because if I wasn't getting enough played across Canada, I wouldn't want 4 Juno Awards and multiple more awards. Look, too much. The room is full. So it's going to show you that radio station and all that is playing Exco Levi across Canada. But when it comes to the dance now, where our people, you know, Jamaican people, people who listen to reggae music, the core, you know, there's a lot of dance keep every week. When I attend these dance privately, sometimes artists don't, selectors don't even know some of them. Me know you know Exco Levi play, and guess what? Some of the rhythm them when me dip on them a plate. You understand, but they will play the most popular song. Like for instance, I mean, Strive is a big Juno Award winning song. It play on the radio regular, but I don't hear it in the dance. So I get to realize that these selectors nowadays, they are just playing this the song to get a hype. Like if it's the most popular song on the rhythm, then just stick on it and then they jump to the next rhythm, and you know. So I decided to say, all right, I'm going to form my own sound system. You understand? It'll play everybody else's music, but it's some music where some people don't play. They might play them, and it's not me alone as an artist in general, because there's a lot of artist friends I have in Jamaica. When me no hear them song playing a dance, I'm no joke, me no hear no Ivan Mara play in a dance in Canada, I'm not going to lie, him play on the radio. But in a dance, I'm going to our people them. You understand? Me no hear no Ivan Mara, me hardly hear busy, I'm a busy signal, so I'm not lie. You understand? It's just a truth. So, me call busy, I'm say busy, listen, me a farmer one sound system, because we have the power in Canada, we can establish whatever, because we do it, because I've established Exco Levi in 10 years in this country. So I'm forming my own sound system, get to you to play. I'm gonna play every music, but me not showing us we have our space in a dance hall. Me and the rest of artists, bridges in Jamaica and across the world, who may hear them play it. We start out with some mixtape. You understand? Right now, we have a guy designed the logo, so it's HP movement, high priest movement, and you know, so it's fully powered by a busy signal turf, because you know, my brother that. You understand? And we are playing everybody music, but we don't show us our music have been played in the dance, because you need the street. You know, you need the street. So I just decided that I'm going to form my own sound system here in Canada and just propel them to the highest level, to the deepest depths. Yeah, man.
Will you just be the sound owner, or will you be selecting or MCing at all?
No, selecting. I won't be selecting. I won't be playing. I have a team who will respond for that part, you know? Just make sure so the mixtape them is out. You know, like every quarter will come out with a mixtape, you know, and me is just gonna be in the background. Owned by Exco Levi, but me have people, you know, who's gonna control it and make sure so that, you know, it's propelled to the highest level. Yeah, man.
What about events? Would you play at any event that you were asked to play at, or would you only look to play at a certain type of event?
No, once the sound system, you know, we're gonna play every kind of music, you know, because my manager, Jones and Jones Production, they are one of the biggest production promotion company in Canada. Jones and Jones, they're 27 years. So the Jones and Jones don't only keep reggae events. They get hired to put on different pop events and whatever. So my DJ, the DJ have to be popular. Have to be versatile, I must say, you know? Every genre of music, playing the roots, playing dancehall. You understand? Once it's positive and clean and uplifting. And I just say that. You understand?
Are you able to say who your selectors are?
Well, from my mate at posting, and I went on the radio and said, listen, I've been getting too much email, too much text. Esca, I want to play the song. But listen, I don't want to use a selector that is already brainwashed out there. I want to find two fresh youth who know the music and want to do it, you know, and just make it into a business. Also, we're going to use that sound system to be one of the main source of distributing reggae music, dance and music across Canada, because we don't have that here. We depend upon what Johnny Wonder blasts out, Ray blasts out, and Ray, you understand? So you get to understand that sometimes most of our content is lost in the vault. because people just looking at Jamaica. So whenever a person have a new song, they can send it to HP Movement. And we just get it to the radio personnel, because we have every radio station, every major DJs in across Canada. Exco Levi, I have them on their phone, right? So I don't have them email. I'm going to only send them my music. Me send, once the music is nice, me send it to them. You understand? Once it's good and the content is good, me send it. So we're going to use that as a medium too. Whenever someone have a new song, once it's positive and uplifting, you know, so this is my thing there. You cannot send it. I'm going to send it to all the major DJs them across Canada. Because me know them personally, me and my friend. You understand?
A few months ago, you traveled to Africa, Zimbabwe and Malawi, I believe, with Busy Signal. Was this your first trip to the continent?
Yeah, this is my first time in Africa, and it won't be the last. I'm telling you that for sure.
Was it an eye-opening experience for you? Did Africa surpass your expectations?
By far. You know, by far. I mean, what you watch on CNN and watch on CBC and all these radio, TV station and outlet, you get to realize that it's totally the opposite. I mean, this is the first surprise I get when I realize that, I mean, people in Africa have things. People in Africa drive Benz and Bimmers and Jaguars, and you know, it surprised me, because I never expected that. You understand? But it's a joy to go there and see that, you know, our race, people of color, we are successful in business, you know, entrepreneur, all of those things. So it's a joy. But when it comes to music now, I was more surprised. And you could see the response on YouTube when Busy called me out, because I didn't expect that. But it just goes to show you that once you're singing positive and uplifting music, somewhere in the world, people are still listening. So Europe never surprised me, because I get a lot of response from Europe, and I tour Europe a lot of the time. But Africa certainly surprised me when I see the response, you know? I give thanks.
I think Africa is often overlooked when it comes to a market for reggae music. I've seen some of the photos from the shows you appeared at, and it looks like they were very well attended. Do you know roughly how many people turned out to see you guys?
Yeah, them say a little bit over 50,000 people in the stadium. But outside, what was surprising to me, outside of Zimbabwe, there was probably like 15,000-20,000 people who couldn't come in, because I believe they said the show is 20 US to come in. So like the poor class of people, them, like people them in the gully and the garrison, because they were even planning to do a next show in the garrison for the people who, you know, who couldn't afford to make it to that show. So they say around 50,000, you know, it is a joy.
Were you two getting approached and stopped in the streets by fans as well?
Yes, man, we get this, man. Boozy, we love you, Boozy. Esco, we love you, we love you, we love. Yeah, I love Zimbabwe. Yeah, but love Zimbabwe, I love Malawi, I love Africa. Yeah, man.
I want to get your opinion on one of the hot topics at the moment. After the release of recent singles from Justin Bieber and Rihanna, people have been discussing the subject of pop acts putting out dancehall and reggae influenced tracks. What are your thoughts on this? Is it a good thing? Are they paying tribute to reggae and dancehall, or are they copying and using Jamaican music for their own benefit?
No, but we as Jamaican people sing over a lot of pop song too. I mean, for us singers sing over a lot of cover, they call it cover, a lot of pop song, a lot of popular song from back in the days. So to me, it's just vice versa. I mean, once a person do a good rendition of the song, it's just more powerful reggae music, man. I'm more powerful dancehall music. That is just my opinion. Probably other people might think different, but I'm not going to think about it like they're stealing our culture. Because you can't steal reggae. And you can't steal dancehall. That is Jamaica. No matter how you do it, that is from Jamaica. People know that. Just like how Isle is from India and Middle East, reggae and dancehall is Jamaica. You can't steal it. You can sing it, you can use it, but you can't steal it. You can't steal something that is embedded in somebody. Yeah, we walk reggae, we sing reggae, we live reggae. So you'll kill that. You understand?
I guess the reason why some people don't like it is because even if a reggae artist was to make a pop song or a cover of a pop song and it sold well, they still wouldn't be getting anywhere near the money Rihanna or Justin Bieber is getting from one of their singles, due to the huge amount of sales they get from all around the world.
No, but pop music, you know, how old when it comes to record sale is way better than most of the other genres. We as reggae musicians and dancehall musicians, we make music from touring. We don't make music from record sale anyways. A long time record stop sale and stop press. We make music, we don't have the resource for market our album like that to make it sale. We might make a little thing here and there on iTunes, but that's nothing. The more popular our song get and our culture get is the more money we make as artists, because we make money from tour and dub plate. That is just the mere fact, you see me? A dub plate, I show we make money off of. So when me sing a song and it get popular, you know, you get a little royalty check here and there, but that's still nothing than what you make from shows. So the more popular the song, better the more the culture reggae artists eat food. So that's how it goes. We can't fool ourselves.
I know you're a football man, that's soccer for the American and Canadian people watching. Am I correct that you play for an amateur team?
Amateur professional team. So I play for a team here in Brampton, in my city, you know. I scored yesterday, you know. So I got my second goal in 3 match for the season, which is good. If you notice, me, I lose a lot of weight, okay? You know, no rice, no bread, no flour. We're on a quinoa diet. You know, you have to take your spices, very important. You have to eat properly, exercise. So to tell you the truth, me can't go out there and run a man in time because I'm lazy like that. But you see, from football, me play it. About 7 days a week, me run on the field and play. That is just my enjoyment. So football and music. Yeah, man.
How is the team doing this season and what position do you play?
Well, I play forward and midfield, you know. When they need a goal, they must put me for forward, you see me? And when they need the ball to distribute, they must drop me at the centre. Because that's where my major. And the team is doing well. We lose 2 much, draw 1 and win 1. Season is still early. But the thing is, me might not die if I complete the season. Because last year we won, but I wasn't here. Yeah, you know, me feel the road sometimes. So I just enjoyment. I love it.
When it comes to watching the real big time ballers, which professional team do you support?
Well, I tell you the truth, when he's a true lover of football, you know, can people fool themselves all the time. When he's a true lover of the sports, you kind of love every team once they're doing well. But you might have a favorite team, but you still don't rule out the fact that, listen, this team is doing well. Because when it comes to playing football, I understand the game. It's different from when you just watch it from the sideline. But when you understand the logistic of football, I understand, you know, the routine, and you see a team playing well for a season, you have to like them. You understand? That's what I'm saying. Me love Barcelona, and me love Liverpool. Me love those two sides, like, to my heart. But when you see a side that go and go like Leicester, you have to just Vardy, bad. You still have to just give them the support. You understand? I just say, God, so me stay. Me is a man, love every team. But me love Barca and and Liverpool, you know? But once a team is doing well, me support them and give thanks. Yeah, man.
Since the move to Toronto, have you become a Raptors, Blue Jays or Maple Leafs fan, or is it strictly football?
Well, you know, I like the Raptors, you know. I mean, I watched 2 of them game before. You know, and I like them, you know, because it's my city. You have to support them. And I saw it go, because living in Jamaica, I never knew that I could actually sit down in an NBA game. When I come back here and I buy my ticket and go watch them and say, yes, yeah, you live in the city, you have to support, because it's a patriotic youth, you understand? And I saw it go. When it come to Blue Jays, no, I don't know about them, because I don't play hockey and I cook hockey. And you know, so I don't really know about the Blue Jays part, because I can't skate, I'm in the ice business there. And my style, and come to the next one, you know. Baseball is not my thing. I don't understand the sport. I don't understand rugby either. I don't understand it. I don't know. My brother try to teach me about it, but I don't understand how it works. So me just a football, soccer, man, and music, reggae music, yeah, man.
If you want to hear more music from this man, check out his 2015 album, Countryman, which is available on iTunes now. Look out for him touring Europe this summer, and I'm sure he has plenty of shows coming up in Canada too. Exco, congratulations again on the Juno nomination. Best of luck on April the 3rd. Is there anything else you'd like to mention before I let you go?
positive music coming from Exco Levi. And for this year 2016, I'm gonna do some different kind of song. You know what I mean? We have a lot of reggae song. We wanna do some crossover song, some happier song. Like for instance, I have song like Let Me Love You, Let Me Love You, and Consequence, True Color Rhythm, doing well. I have song like Girl, You're Pretty Like Canadian Money, Darling My Honey, Really Wanna Get to Know You. Some look a nice little happy song. I just said that. And you know, continue praising Rastafari, that's it. Love yourself, people. Exco Levi, Gibbo, I must commend you too, you know. I mean, for the good work you've been doing, you know. Highlighting our culture across the world. I mean, there's not a lot of artists who are commending, but I have to commend you. For you to take this initiative to look out for the best of our interests and doing your interview, you know, it's awesome motivation for I and I too. Just to show that you don't have to be an artist, because artists always think that the business align around them alone. Nah. The music industry involves you too. Because if you don't do this interview, people won't know what's going on with Exco Levi. Radio personnel, journalists, all of them is a part of the industry. So music business don't base on artists alone because we have the lead mic. So stop fooling yourself. Big up yourself, Gibbo. I commend you and all the journalists across the world and media personnel. Big up. Rastafari.
Gibbo presents.